Right, I have an iPhone 5 that has a random shutdown problem, and it happened about 2 weeks ago, where it just randomly shut down without any warning at all. And then just yesterday, when it shut down, I tried to turn it back on, just like it usually happened within the last 2 weeks. It turns on to this Apple logo, and after a couple minutes, it will just turn off and give me a black screen. That's it. It doesn't want to turn on anymore. And I tried to turn it back on again, and it shows the Apple logo, and then it just turned off by itself and does not want to turn on. So I thought the battery has a problem, so I disassembled the phone. This is the picture I took when I disassembled the phone. And I removed the battery and I tried to test it, and it shows a full voltage. It shows 4.2 volts. It's fully charged. I tried to replace with another battery, but the old battery still holds a full charge. So it was not the problem with the battery. So I put it back together and I tried to restore it using iTunes. I'm sure you have to restore the phone, iPhone 5. Using iTunes. So first you gotta turn off your phone. Alright, just slide it and turn it off. And then when it's already off, you use your USB cable, plug in your computer, and then press and hold this home button. Don't release it. And then at the same time, you plug in the USB port right here, plug it in, and then it will show the Apple logo. Keep holding it, and then for like 5-10 seconds, it will show the restore icon. Then you can just use iTunes and restore the phone with the newest firmware. Just download the newest firmware and just restore it. And also, when I try to restore it, it first gave me this error, 3194. I tried to Google it, but it doesn't really help me much. So I keep on restoring it, keep on trying for the second, third, and fourth time. I think the fourth time it actually went through and actually restored the phone. And to show you now, it's working just fine now. No problem at all. With the newest version, with the newest firmware. So it's actually a software problem, not a hardware problem. I was guessing because I didn't drop the phone or make it wet or anything like that, so it doesn't have any physical damage to it. So if you have the same problem, just try to restore it. It might, you know, might be able to fix it.